Storm Gale coated the plains with snow already today. This is a look at the mess that Gale left across portions of Nebraska. Some slick roads out there. Certainly the grassy surfaces coated in white. And now we'll watch farther east as the storm system takes aim on the Northeast Corridor, where more than 70 million people are under winter storm alerts tonight, most of those in the Northeast, because as Gale pushes east, it'll bring snow, wind, and ice from the Appalachians in western North Carolina all the way up to coastal Maine, at least to some degree, with a big bullseye in between. Speaking of that big bullseye in between, look at some of these snowfall numbers that we're talking about here for the Northeast. Some areas that could push up to 2 feet of snow in Pennsylvania up to New York. It looks like that Scranton to Binghamton corridor, that kind of region, may be the big winners here when all is said and done. But it doesn't mean a non-event for the I-95 corridor either, and some of the big cities that will be impacted here. In fact, 95 million people are seeing wintry weather through the history of this storm, from Oklahoma City to Ohio to D.C. to Pennsylvania, New York through New England. If you are in any of these cities on your screen, some pretty big snow is in your metro area within the next 24 hours. So we're staying live tonight until 1 a.m. Eastern, 12 Central, tracking this growing and soon to be really big monster storm. I'm Storm Specialist Mark Elliott, Storm Specialist Carl Parker here as well. Carl, gosh, the heaviest snow totals that many have seen in years. A place like Philadelphia, it's not saying much. Last season was what, 0.3?
Right.
When all is said and done, so this will be an easy beat there.
Yeah, it's going to be an amazing storm on so many counts. So very heavy snow, a lot of strong wind, coastal flooding, could be some flooding as well, regular rainfall flooding. Let's take a look, first of all, at the snowfall forecast for the Northeast. Now, it is, as is often the case, not a very high confidence forecast on the southern edge, because you see that sharp gradient going from heavy snow to almost none over a really short distance. So any little variation in the track of the low or the dynamics of the storm could make a difference in terms of who gets what. But right now it looks like the worst of it is going to be northwest of 95 in Maryland as well as in New Jersey. And then up into southern New England, we're going to get more into that heavy snow across that 95 corridor. And there you see the terrific amounts in northeast Pennsylvania, Bloomsburg, Lewisburg, Scranton, up into the Catskills there into Binghamton, all those areas looking at a foot and a half, maybe as much as 2 feet, or even more than that in some spots. So this storm now taking shape in the middle of the country. See the big swirl in the atmosphere? That's going to help to induce an area of low pressure in the southeast tomorrow morning. The other really critical part of this is the high pressure to the north. That's going to deliver fresh, cold air down into the northeast. That's a really important component in these winter storms. And then the storm, as it moves up and along the coast, grabs moisture off the Atlantic, takes it and throws it into that colder air, and the result is that we see all that heavy snow. And because there's going to be a lot of jet stream energy, that's going to make the low a lot stronger as it's moving up the coast, and it's going to be driving a strong flow in across a temperature gradient, and that lift will set up that heavier banding that's going to bring us all that heavy snow. So here's a model forecast showing you how this could very well play out. You see the snow developing into the middle of the day tomorrow in southern Pennsylvania, in the D.C. Metro as well. We're going to see a change over there in D.C. and Baltimore to rain. Most likely we'll talk more about that in a moment. Also, the winds start to get really strong, and there's going to be very heavy rain in those areas that get the rain, southern Maryland as well as the Delmarva, and a lot of wind coming into Philly tomorrow evening. Could easily be enough wind to cause some power outages, maybe drop some tree limbs or some power lines. And then here we go into 5 o'clock in the morning. Very strong wind, heavy snow there again from 95 and on northwestward, including the tri-state area, much of it anyway, and we'll be looking at most likely some near blizzard conditions, maybe even bona fide blizzard conditions in some isolated areas. And then into Thursday, 1 o'clock in the afternoon, wind still going strong, the snow winding down there in New England, and then finally everything begins to move out as we get into later Thursday. I want to show you some of these winds here because they are going to be really impressive, talking about 40 to 50 miles per hour in Philly. So along the Jersey Shore, Mark, we could be talking about winds gusting to 60 miles per hour. And as you know, that is easily enough to cause some power outages and maybe even some structural damage. Also, coastal flooding will be a very big concern. Mark?
Yeah, we're, 2 days away from the new moon. So I think that wind combined with the high tide levels will be a factor for the storm. The other big impact factor that we're going to be be watching in a place like Philadelphia and many other cities is that it's going to be right up against that rain-snow line. We are keeping a close eye on the forecast models along I-95. The Weather Channel's Mike Seidel is in the city of Brotherly Love tonight with a look at how they are preparing for what could be the biggest storm they've seen in years. Mike.
Here in Philadelphia, they only picked up 0.3 inches of snow all of last winter. That meant certainly less overtime for the plow drivers, the plow operators. And how about this guy? He knows about that. This is Richard Montanez. He is the deputy commissioner of Philadelphia Streets. You've been with the department 25 years. In fact, you once drove a plow. What's more fun, driving the plow or managing the plow operators?
I personally like driving the plow. Managing means I get to do interviews, meet people like you. So they both got their pluses and minuses.
Well, that was certainly nice to say. Let's talk about what's going on now. Last winter, partly a flake. Tomorrow, we're expecting, you know, at least 3 or 4 inches in the city, at least on the front end of the system. What have you done to prep the streets for this storm today?
So we started brining the streets today. We have about 75 miles of streets already brined. We're going to continue that till about midnight. Then we're going to start flipping some of that fleet over for salting and plowing. We'll have about 75 vehicles ready in the morning to go. After sanitation fleet picks up the trash, we'll start flipping that fleet over. That fleet should be ready around 3:30, 4 p.m. for the afternoon rush. That gives us roughly over 225 city plows, and then we'll complement that with another 150, 160 contractor plows.
And I would suspect because of last year's almost snowless winter that you have plenty of salt.
So we're starting this storm, with 50,000 tons of salt in our domes. We're full to capacity, and we're planning to utilize it as we need it tomorrow.
Okay, Richard Montanez, thanks for joining us.
Sure.
Good luck tomorrow. And you'd like to see the rain snow line west or east of Philadelphia?
I like to see it west of Philadelphia.
I had a feeling you were going to say that. Okay, we'll see where it ends up. And again, it's going to be somewhere right near Philadelphia. The farther north and west you go, the higher totals. But we're also going to have wind. That's going to mean power outages. So lots of impacts, regardless if you get 4 inches or 12 to 14 inches here in Philadelphia.
Thank you, Mike. Yeah, Philadelphia may be stealing some of the headlines, but Carl, we want to kind of go city by city here. We'll go south to north and kind of break down all of the intricacies that could happen with a winter storm and how important that rain-snow line is going to be.
Oh, yeah, it's hugely important. And we want to take you into D.C. and show you how things are going to be changing pretty dramatically through the course of the day tomorrow. Quiet tonight, and it will be tomorrow morning. We're just going to start to see the snow coming in through the morning hours, maybe about mid-morning is when it really sets up in earnest. And it will be snowing probably pretty well for a couple of hours at least. Let's take a look at the forecast here and go hour by hour. So here you go into tomorrow morning, 10 o'clock in the morning. The snow is starting to come in at that time. You notice where that rain snow line is there. There's going to be a little bit of a mix in between the rain and the snow. There's going to be some sleet and maybe some freezing rain as well. Then we go into about noon and we're starting to see that rain snow line migrating a little farther north. And so it's probably mostly going to be heavier rain in southern Maryland, PG County, Charles County, down across the bay into the Delmarva, maybe some flash flooding as well, a lot of wind on top of that. And then we'll watch that rain snow line really migrate, I mean, get all the way up almost to the Mason-Dixon line. So it's going to completely change over to rain in Baltimore and D.C. through a lot of the day tomorrow. Then in the very tail end of everything, we see another little area of snow coming through and some colder temperatures. So when you talk about amounts, probably not that much in Baltimore and D.C., but you can see, again, that gradient is very, very close. So a little bit of a deviation in this forecast could make a very big difference. That's what we want you to know. Mark, in this area in particular, that is not a high confidence forecast, as just a little bit of a shift could change things dramatically.
I can already hear the cries of the D.C. snow hole beginning once again. I think they're going to be echoed in Philadelphia though. Philadelphia, which we've mentioned, had such a terrible snow year for the snow lovers last year with 0.3 for an entire season. Here's another chance for some snow, although I think you're going to see a little bit of everything. I think there will be some mixing, maybe get into all rain for the Philadelphia area, and a little bit of mixing goes a long way to limit those snowfall totals. Gosh, you look at the streak that we've been on with the longest stretch between one-inch snowfalls, the record 661, our current streak 652. We certainly haven't seen a one-inch snowfall yet this year, but will this one be the storm that does it? Gosh, it's close, right? Talk about a low confidence forecast. Look at this line from absolutely nothing from like the Mount Holly, New Jersey office, which controls like the National Weather Service office for Philadelphia. It's right here. It's a suburb, right? Rain, no snow accumulation at all. To maybe as much as 3 or 4 or 5 in Philadelphia to just north and west a foot plus. That is a crazy gradient across the Philadelphia area. Here's how it all comes into play. Starting as steady snow in Philadelphia, but look at that rain line come in. You might warm up to the low 40s. Hard to get a good accumulating snowfall when you get quite that warm, maybe ending as a snowflake or two. But if you don't get that burst of snow early on in the Philadelphia area, Carl, it might not happen because of that cutoff with the warm air coming in.
Yeah, always a very tricky forecast along that 95 corridor with these storms. And there you see a live look at New York City. And we're expecting your heaviest snow to come in tomorrow evening. It's probably going to start as a lighter snow, but will pick up rapidly. It will become a burst of snow 7 to 8 to 9 o'clock tomorrow night. We could be looking at snowfall rates at that time of 1 to 2 to 3 inches per hour. So it's really going to be coming down tomorrow evening. And at the same time, the winds are also going to be stepping up as we go through the night. So we could get close to that blizzard criteria, seeing some quarter-mile visibility and winds at 35 miles per hour or higher over a few hours. That will be possible, certainly, in the overnight. You see how high the winds are getting there? Sustained 32, 36 miles per hour. It's definitely not going to be easy. And again, as I mentioned, that bursting of snow early on, that will probably continue through the overnight. Now, this forecast is not quite as difficult. We think that rain snow line is, for the most part, going to be to the south of the tri-state area, but it depends on where you are, of course. If you're a little farther south, if you're more towards Staten Island, Northern Jersey, southern part of Long Island, then we get into more of that rain and more of that mix. So there's the snow coming in. As I mentioned, through the evening, it's really going to be stepping up. There's going to be this period from 7 to 8 to 9 where the snowfall rates are very, very heavy and the winds are increasing as well. Then we see that going through the overnight. You start to see that rain snow line getting closer, though. And here, too, it's very, very tricky where you see that gradient. If it gets a little farther north, well, that obviously is going to cut down on your totals. And it's also possible that some drier air is going to be coming into New York in the middle of this. And that, too, would tend to really cut down on the totals. But right now, what we're thinking is it's going to be most likely somewhere around 8 to 12 inches in the city, and then quite a bit more as you get farther north and west, and a lot of wind on top of that. And we're talking about wind that may rise to the level of some power outages there in Long Island and southern Connecticut in particular. Mark?
And you know, just farther north from there, I think we start to lose that rain snow line debate. And the question is, how long do we stay in the heavy snow? How many hours straight do we stay in the heavy snow with the wind? That includes Hartford, Providence, and Boston, as you're looking at here with the cloud cover just slowly starting to stream on in. And gosh, it is going to be a big storm across this area of southern New England. We'll start out by looking at the forecast map for, say, Hartford to Providence and the kind of the southern and western suburbs of Boston. A fairly widespread foot snowfall on the way. Again, you're not going to see that rain snow line get in here. That cold air is there. And with the movement of our low, I don't think that warmth from the ocean ever gets in. We'll have cold air rushing in with that northwest wind. So in the Hartford area, we're in heavy snow for, you know, hours straight from, let's say, the late evening hours Wednesday all the way through the beginning of your morning on Thursday. And look at the wind at that same time. Could be gusting over 30 miles per hour through that whole stretch. Tree branches could come down. down power line issues because of that. Here's a look at the Boston area itself. This is a pretty big storm for you. A foot, maybe even a foot and a half in some cases here, 12 to 16 inches of snow. No risk of that mixing. No risk of the rain-snow line here. Our low is not coming right up the coast and coming towards Boston. It's going to be heading out to the east, which will allow for that cold air to fill back in, but you're still close enough to get that moisture thrown back into it. I think it is going to be a pretty big storm. It's rare to get these types of big snows in early December in Boston, but Carl, this might be one of them.
Certainly could, and we want to again go over everything that's going to be happening here in the next couple of days and show you the advisories that are now out. These are winter storm warnings from the Appalachians right up into the southern part of New England. No blizzard warnings as of yet. That may change at the last minute as they continue to refine the forecast. And here you see that ice is also going to be a big issue. Southwest Virginia and western parts of North Carolina there, we think a high confidence that we'll see at least a tenth of an inch of ice accumulation in those areas. So let's talk about the timing once again. The snow will be coming in tomorrow morning into D.C., coming up into western Pennsylvania across the turnpike there, moving into New York in the evening hours. Very heavy snowfall early on, heavier snowfall rates in New York. There you see the rain snow line has gone well to the north of D.C. and Baltimore, really close there in the tri-state area, but it is thought that you are likely going to be getting maybe as much as a foot of snow in New York City. Then 5 o'clock in the morning, still seeing some very strong wind there across New York as well as into New England, and the low begins to move out as we get into a Thursday afternoon. So major storm on the way for the Northeast. We'll have much more in this developing situation coming up in a moment.
Trilogy for COPD.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day.
No matter how you got COPD, it's time to make a stand.
And I'm feeling.
Start a new day with Trelegy. No once daily COPD medicine has the power to treat COPD in as many ways as Trelegy. With three medicines and one inhaler, Trelegy helps people breathe easier and improves lung function. It also helps prevent future flare-ups. Trelegy won't replace a rescue inhaler for sudden breathing problems. Tell your doctor if you have a heart condition or high blood pressure before taking it. Do not take Trelegy more than prescribed. Trelegy may increase your risk of thrush, pneumonia, and osteoporosis. Call your doctor if worsened breathing, chest pain, mouth or tongue swelling, problems urinating, vision changes, or eye pain occur. It's time to start a new day. Ask your doctor about once daily Trelegy.
One of the worst things about a cold sore is how it can make you feel. But when used at the first sign, Abreva can get you back to being you in just 2.5 days. Be kinder to yourself and tougher on your cold sores.
Box of Townhouse Crackers, I'm craving adventure.
With me, the possibilities are endless. Hot buffalo, spicy queso, frosting.
You do taste good with everything.
I know.
Anything can be a dip with Townhouse.
Wendy's Baconator is the ultimate bacon cheeseburger that's got all other cheeseburgers feeling like... And now with the Breakfast Baconator, we're shaking and waking up your breakfast, bringing that big bacon energy all day long. So get to Wendy's and always be baconating.
My psoriatic arthritis pain? I had enough. It's not getting in my way.
Joint pain, swelling, tenderness, much better.
My psoriasis, clearer. Cosentyx works on all of this.
4 years and counting.
So watch out.
I got this.
Watch me.
Real people with active psoriatic arthritis look and feel better with Cosentyx. Cosentyx works fast for results that can last. It treats the multiple symptoms of psoriatic arthritis, like joint pain and tenderness, back pain, and helps stop further joint damage. Don't use if you're allergic to Cosentyx. Before starting, get checked for tuberculosis. An increased risk of infections and lowered ability to fight them may occur. Tell your doctor about an infection or symptoms. If your inflammatory bowel disease symptoms develop or worsen, or if you've had a vaccine or plan to, serious allergic reactions may occur.
I just look and feel better.
I got real relief with Cosentyx.
Watch me.
Feel real relief. Ask your rheumatologist about Cosentyx.
We made USAA insurance for veterans like Martin. When a hailstorm hit, he needed his insurance to get it done right. Right away. USAA. What you're made of, we're made for.
USAA. This year we got creative with our dollars. But with Walmart's low prices, you still know how to do it up and keep costs down. Let's end the year enjoying more.
All right, following a big deal winter storm coming into the Northeast Corridor and down through the Mid-Atlantic. But before it got there, it did this in the center of the country, a couple more inches to the totals in the Oklahoma City area. An impressive streak you've been on. Three different winter storms already this year, basically all of them touching the Oklahoma City area. 6 inches of snow now or so in Oklahoma City? It's an impressive stat for a city that's reasonably far south. But that's just the beginning. The Mid-Atlantic into the Northeast, that's where the big deal snow is coming. That's where preparations started today for this major winter storm. This is I-95 near Fredericksburg, Virginia, pre-treating the roads with that brine, the salt in the sand, to try to make it so that the frozen precipitation does not bond to the roadway. It's going to be a tough go for the road crews across the Northeast. Look at some of these numbers. It's not that often that you see a snowfall footprint like this. Widespread totals above a foot, a decent amount of real estate above a foot and a half to even 2 feet of snow. That's a big time snow over the interior of the Northeast and the Mid-Atlantic. And yet there's still a real tricky cutoff line that'll go right through D.C. to Baltimore, right through Philly, right through New Brunswick, New Jersey. Philadelphia, you're on that line. You're on that rain snow line where north and west of you, heavy, heavy snow. South and east, rain, maybe almost nothing. So what we want to do is go right into Center City and bring in our own Mike Seidel, who is monitoring the model runs and really seeing how that that city is getting ready for the first major winter storm in several years now. Mike.
It's been 652 days since Philadelphia saw their last one-inch snowfall, March of 2019. Last winter, they only had 0.3 inches of snow. Can you believe that? They average about 22 and change. So tomorrow, the snow drought ends with winter storm Gale. The first flakes arrive around midday, early afternoon. And today, not only in the city, but out in the suburbs, they were prepping the roadways. Take a look at the brine solution. You can see it on the roadways. This is what they put down to prep the roads before the snow falls. And if it doesn't rain, it does a pretty good job. Here in the city of Philadelphia, they did this on 75 miles of roads, bridges, and overpasses. They've got 75 plows ready. They're going to put the blades tomorrow late morning after they pick up the trash on the sanitation trucks. Plus, they have private contractors. And because of last year's snow drought, they are going into the season very nicely with over 50,000 tons of salt. The big question here in Philadelphia, where does a rain snow line end up tomorrow night? That will cut down on accumulations. Right now here in the city, we're thinking about 4 or 5 inches. But again, out in the suburbs where it's going to be colder, you get out towards northern and western Chester County. That's Valley Forge, the Chesterbrook area, northern Bucks County, northern Montgomery County. That's where you could see double-digit snowfall. The last time we had 6 inches of snow here in Philadelphia was back in March of 2018. I'm meteorologist Mike Seidel, the Weather Channel in Center City, Philly.
Been a long time since a storm was even close to the Philadelphia area, but this one is problematic, Carl. I'm not convinced that that warm air doesn't very quickly mess with the snowfall totals around the Philadelphia area.
Well, you know, that's the funny thing is that you could end up getting, you know, say 3, 4, or 5 inches of snow, but then the rain comes in and it takes a lot of that away. So, you know, what's the practical application of that? Maybe you officially get something, but what do you
just
actually
end up
seeing?
Just enough to end the record.
Right.
That's basically what it comes down to.
Yeah.
That heavy rain is going to wash away just about anything that falls.
It is, very much so. And so, you know, that makes this a really difficult forecast along the 95 corridor. And you know, this is not, as anybody who lives here knows, this is not an unusual thing. It just so happens that that rain-snow line tends to set up across the areas of highest population in the Northeast. So it makes it a difficult forecast for a lot of people. Right now, the best guess is that we're going to see less snow in Baltimore and D.C. You're going to see the snow line, rain snow line, sort of bisecting the Philly metro area, so a lot more on the north side and hardly anything on the south side, and that it's going to be probably just a little to the south of New York City, putting New York City more squarely in the snow, but certainly so as you get farther north and west. But, you know, again, that's, you know, all based on the current thinking about the track of the storm. And the models do seem to be settling in on this idea, but certainly models can be wrong. We've seen it many times, and oftentimes, you know, rather than just having sort of a clean line there, it sort of wavers, goes back and forth. You get some areas where there's a little more warm air intrusion and some areas where there's a little less. The upshot is that, you know, we'll do our best to give you our best forecast, but it's going to be a tricky one for a lot of these major metros, but not at all for central and northeast Pennsylvania, southeast New York. Those areas are going to get pounded. We'll have much more on the storm coming up in a few minutes.
Let Marcos bring comfort to the holidays with the ultimate comfort food. Enjoy unlimited medium one-topping pizzas for just $6.99 each. Served hot and safe. Order for carryout or contact-free delivery at marcos.com.
Enjoy America's most loved pizza and contact-free delivery from Marcos.
One taste of Nespresso Virtuo, and Michaela G. writes, one taste and you'll discover what coffee is meant to be. Nespresso Virtuo.
Someday, I'm going to marry you. Someday, we'll buy that little place on Ellsworth. Some days, well, 50 years will have gone by, and I'll ask you to marry me all over again.
Someday.
Wow, a new Buick for me?
To James from James. That's just what I wanted.
Is this a new Buick?
I secret Santa'd myself.
I shouldn't have. I have been very good this year.
Wow. Wow.
Wow.
Don't forget you this holiday season. Get an SUV from Buick. Celebrate the holidays with Buick. Now everyone can get GM employee pricing on most Buick SUV models. Use it to get over $4,500 total value on this Encore GX.
Before Nexium 24-Hour, Anna could only imagine a comfortable night's sleep without frequent heartburn waking her up. Now, that dream is her reality. Nexium 24-Hour stops acid before it starts for all-day, all-night protection. Can you imagine 24 hours without heartburn?
Here's to the experiences we create. The moments we share. Wherever we are. San Pellegrino. Enhance your moments.
She wants him to eat something good this morning. He wants it to be skate o'clock. So she came prepared with Nutri-Grain. Made with real fruit and whole grains kids will actually eat. Kellogg's Nutri-Grain. Come prepared.
Who is USAA made for? It's made for this guy, a veteran who honorably served. And it's made for her. She's serving now. We made it for all branches and all ranks, whether they served one tour or made a career of it. We also made USAA for military spouses and their kids. USAA is easy to work with and can save you money on auto, home, and renter's insurance. Become a member today. Call us for a quote. USAA, what you're made of, we're made for. USAA.
How do you make a Pinot Noir taste like no other? Start with grapes from three California regions. Push flavor in new directions. And put a bear on the label. Made like no other for a taste like no other. Mayomi. Flavor forward.
I watch the weather. And I talk about the weather. When everyone else on the plane is watching movies, I'm looking out the window. Out there, big puffy mountains float. They say it's boring to talk about the weather. I say it's boring not to. Get into the out there. The Weather Channel.
I honestly don't want to see it. It's too early. I'd rather see it come in January and February.
Well, less than 24 hours, the biggest winter storm the Northeast and Mid-Atlantic have seen in years will be in full swing, bringing with it snow amounts measured in feet, winds of 50, 60 miles per hour, flooding rain, potentially coastal flooding, and of course, an awful lot of cold. And here's a look at the snowfall we're expecting. An enormous area of more than a foot of snow. A lot of confidence about that forecast in central Pennsylvania and northeast Pennsylvania and southeast New York, northern Jersey, and a lot of New England. Much less confidence about the southern edge of that, which just happens to be where there are millions of people living. really tricky forecast for, say, Philly and to some extent for D.C., Baltimore, and also New York, less so in Boston. And we're also going to be looking at some freezing rain there in the western part of Virginia. One of the cities we're watching closely tonight is Philadelphia. Winter storm warning in effect. Snow amounts are going to vary, but they could top over a foot on the north side of the metro area. So, you know, that's a really critical part of this forecast in Philly. We think that the farther north you are relative to downtown, the better your chances of getting a major snowstorm are. If you're south of Philly, you may not see much of anything beyond rain and wind. And let's talk about how some areas are getting ready for this major storm. And let's start in the Philly area. Our affiliate WCAU shows us the one thing that's been flying off the shelves.
Are you ever tempted to ask people, your customers...
What do they do with a shovel? I knew you were going to say that. Yeah, it amazes me. I think they either break it or it gets rent over or something, you know, in the garage. I don't know.
It never fails. The first mention of snow, and Lewis Hollett says the customers come in.
Yeah, they started yesterday. Yeah, we were busy yesterday with not snow blowers yet. They won't buy a snow blower until they see some accumulation.
But what we'll see depends on where you live.
Today, we're trying to get all the trucks ready, get all the spreaders. We're still collecting leaves, so we had to take leaf boxes off, put salt spreaders on.
Workers at Plymouth Township Public Works will flip equipment on trucks to aid in salting and plowing. They just don't know yet what they're going to be doing and when. If the rain keeps coming, the salt would get washed away. But they'll be working to get something on the roads in case that rain freezes. And when you need a couple of guys working on a two-ton machine, social distancing is hard to manage.
We do have a plan in place.
If the virus were to wreak havoc on one Montgomery County road crew, the fear is untreated roads would be there in an entire town. So public works crews plan to team up and help each other if they need it, which they do hope that they won't have to.
Basically, to any municipality that has a disaster, we're able to help, and municipalities will be able to give up any kind of men that they have to help somebody else.
Helping your neighbors, whether you're a road crew or the average citizen, sometimes when the winter weather knocks on your door, that's what you got to do. The entire New York City metro area also under winter storm warnings now. In the city, up to a foot of snow is possible, especially northern portions of the city. If you get into central New York, 2 feet plus, not off the table yet. So Carl just showed us about the preps in eastern Pennsylvania. Want to hear a little bit more about the New York region from WNBC as preparations are underway there as well.
As bags of salt roll down the street, a last-minute grab for a shovel.
Here's the thing. We're going to get some snow, but you never know with New York. It always plays games with us, you know?
But the MTA is not playing around. The cash-strapped agency already bracing for a rough end of the week after the end of a rough year.
We've activated our 24/7 command center to closely monitor the storm.
A city snow alert ends outdoor dining at 2 p.m. Wednesday. Restaurant owners are not required to take down their structures, but they are asked to secure them, along with tables, chairs, and heaters, as much as possible.
If it's a restaurant that really has built something much more substantial, they can leave it there.
Brisk sales ahead of the cool weather at Paragon Sports in Union Square. Warm coats a top seller today. A bright spot during a rough time for retailers across the city.
Last year was mild, so nobody really went out and rushed to buy things. So this year it's a bit of a scramble.
Bit of a scramble indeed. And here's the thing. I think a lot of you are going to be trying to scramble home a little bit early in the New York area. You heard people mention, oh, there's always that, you know, chance that the weather's going to mess with you in the city. That's a possibility, too. There is a risk to this forecast that some warm air gets in, a change over to at least some rain, maybe Staten Island, you know, real close to Midtown and points north from there. The farther north you go, the more you'll stay as all snow. But the timing important, right? By the kind of mid-afternoon hours, the light snow moves in and quickly goes heavy. So if you're waiting to that, you know, traditional commute home time, you're going to be doing that in the heavy snow. And that's not the time of the storm that the rain might mess with your totals. That's later in the overnight, as the temperatures will actually be climbing a bit in the New York City area as the low approaches, thanks to that southerly wind. So right now, the best forecast splits the city in two and splits Long Island, really, down the LIE. The South Shore, a couple of inches and a rain threat. You know, south side of Manhattan, not nearly as much as the north side of Manhattan, up through Brooklyn and Queens, and then going on off towards the, you know, the southern upstate New York area. That's where it's easily a foot plus. Not as easy in New York City itself and, you know, midtown and downtown, where there could be some mixing, and a little bit of rain really goes a long way to mess with these totals. Why do I think we might mix in some rain? Look at these temperatures. It's marginal at best. 5 o'clock, heavy snow, 30 degrees. That continues through the evening until we pop above 32. Look at the rain along the LIE. Look at the rain for the Jersey Shore. The cutoff basically goes right through portions of the Big Apple, and then the cold air winds back out. So if you stay as all snow the whole time, you're in a sweet spot. Big snowflakes, high moisture content snow, easy for it to pile up, all those things that you'd be looking at for big snows, and a lot of wind as well, so blowing and drifting snow. A big time storm on the way, whether you're on the rain or the snow side.
There's still a few things Americans can agree on. The importance of speed, hard work, and the great outdoors. So we built a future for each of them. We electrified the Mustang and engineered it to get from 0 to 60 in under 4 seconds. Put a hybrid engine in the all-new F-150 that works as hard as it does smart. Then reimagine the Bronco as an off-roading, high-performance wild animal. This is the future we're building, and we're building it today.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens. Bright yellow Lay's bags and noses frostbitten. Snack table spread that is fit for a king. These are a few of my favorite things.
Trelegy for COPD.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day.
No matter how you got COPD, it's time to make a stand.
And I'm feeling.
Start a new day with Trelegy. No once daily COPD medicine has the power to treat COPD in as many ways as Trelegy. With 3 medicines and 1 inhaler, Trelegy helps people breathe easier and improves lung function. It also helps prevent future flare-ups. Trelegy won't replace a rescue inhaler for sudden breathing problems. Tell your doctor if you have a heart condition or high blood pressure before taking it. Do not take Trelegy more than prescribed. Trelegy may increase your risk of thrush, pneumonia, and osteoporosis. Call your doctor if worsened breathing, chest pain, mouth or tongue swelling, problems urinating, vision changes, or eye pain occur. It's time to start a new day. Ask your doctor about once daily Trelegy and save at Trelegy.com.
Box of townhouse crackers, I'm craving adventure.
With me, the possibilities are endless. Hot buffalo, spicy queso, frosting.
You do taste good with everything.
I know.
Anything can be a dip with townhouse.
Mom.
What is that?
It's a star.
Oh.
I didn't have the cutout thing.
What do you think of mine, Grandma?
That's perfect, darling.
I'll put more candy on.
Okay, my turn.
Here we go.
Just like yours, Mom.
Oh, wow, you're terrible.
I think I did something wrong.
Yes.
Okay, everybody, let's start again. One cup of sugar.
Sugar? I think I used a cup of salt.
At Spectrum, we think even if you can't be together, you should still be together.
Didn't he used to be a smart one?
Very funny guy.
So we'll keep you connected. Happy holidays from Spectrum.
I love you too.
This season, spoiling your pets has never been easier when you use free same-day delivery at PetSmart.com powered by DoorDash. Or buy online and choose contactless curbside pickup. The season of spoiling is here. PetSmart.
Do you worry about going to the dentist? With the Carefree Dental Card, you go to the dentist whenever you need and you instantly pay a lot less. The Carefree Dental Card is just $15.95 a month. So call now and make going to the dentist carefree.
Join us on our mission to be informed and inspired. Pattern, available on your favorite platforms.
A winter storm warning is in effect. Currently in our area, 31 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, some clouds, low 29, winds north-northeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Wednesday, snow developing during the afternoon, high 34. Wednesday night, periods of snow and windy, low 32. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Welcome back. The Hurricane Hunters are out. Not because of a hurricane, thankfully, but the same brave members of the Air Force Reserve Weather Reconnaissance Squadron that fly into hurricanes also fly into winter storms. This is their first winter storm mission of the season. Specially equipped WC-130J will gather valuable data about the pressure in winter storm gale, just as they do in hurricanes. And we are looking at a monstrous storm coming for the Northeast. Along with it, we expect that there's going to be very heavy snow through a lot of the interior Northeast. So we're talking about central PA along the Turnpike there for much of the length of the state, the Laurel Mountains, then over into the lower Susquehanna Valley, up into the 80 corridor, 81, particularly as you get up into Scranton and Wilkes-Barre. It could be a foot and a half, maybe 2 feet of snow, Poconos, the Catskills, Binghamton, towards the Capital District, Albany, parts of Western Mass, and then through much of New England as well. All of those areas are going to get pounded by this storm. I mean, there's just no question about that. Where there is question is what's going to be happening on the south side, and that happens to be where there are millions of people. You see, there's a very sharp gradient there where we go from a lot of snow accumulation to none at all. So that is sitting most likely just north of Baltimore and D.C. So most likely we're not going to get a lot of accumulation in Baltimore and D.C. You'll start with snow tomorrow morning, and then we'll transition to rain through a lot of the day, maybe get a little snow on the backside of the system very early on Thursday. Philadelphia is probably going to be sitting right on that line. And so it could very well be that we get quite a bit of snow, maybe a foot in the far northern suburbs and exurbs of Philly, say into northern Bucks County, northern Montgomery County, and then nothing south of town in, say, southern Jersey around Glassboro and then towards the Atlantic City Expressway. And then New York City is going to be more towards heavier snow, but again, that gradient is very close. So rain is going to be creeping in through the course of this event going into late tomorrow and very early Thursday. It's going to be sneaking up into parts of southern Brooklyn and southern Queens and southern Long Island, and that is going to have an effect on those totals. But then as you get north of town, I mean, it's just going to be a foot of snow, most likely for all of those areas that are northwest of Manhattan, talking about White Plains and Patterson and Poughkeepsie, all those spots, Connecticut, all going to get slammed by the storm. So there are tricky parts where it's going to be very hard to figure out exactly what's going to happen. But we do know that as you get farther away from 95 to the north and west, that's where it's going to be a really substantial snowstorm. Now, here's a model forecast showing you snow coming in tomorrow morning in D.C., as I mentioned. Then we see that transition to rain in the afternoon. Snow really starts coming down in the afternoon in Pennsylvania, gets into New York. The snowfall rates tomorrow evening are going to be fantastic, most likely 1 to 2 inches per hour for a time in the evening, and then, you know, continuing through the overnight. And at the same time, the low is also going to be getting a lot stronger. So as that happens, the winds will be increasing. We could be looking at some near blizzard conditions in some parts of the Northeast, and then a lot of wind along the coast. Winds gusting 50, 60 miles per hour in parts of Long Island and New Jersey, and then down towards the Delmarva, and coastal flooding on top of that. So, Mark, a lot of different impacts from this storm, and it's definitely going to be one that is remembered for a while.
Absolutely. This could really be a spectacular windstorm, spectacular in its scope, not necessarily spectacular for its impacts it'll leave, right? A live look at Atlantic City, New Jersey right now, where you are firmly in the warmer side, air quotes, you can't see them, but air quotes for warmer, because it'll be a rainstorm for you. But gosh, tropical storm force winds, high wind watch is in place, coastal flood warning in place, not just for Atlantic City, but for all of the Jersey Shore. This low is going to be doing its closest approach to the Jersey Shore late tomorrow evening into tomorrow night. So this is, I guess, you know, we're after midnight now, so late Wednesday into your Thursday overnight. And with that low, approaching, we are going to see very strong winds. This has a lot of impacts. Not only do we know from hurricane season that the wind moves the water, so that will pile up basically a storm surge, okay? Coastal flooding because of that. That low-level jet will also enhance the snow for the areas where you're in snow, especially where you start picking up the terrain and the elevation naturally comes up. You start getting into the Poconos, for example. That lift from the terrain plus the low-level jet headed that way will really enhance the snowfall rate. But let's go back to the wind, because the wind is going to be such a crucial component here. I'm thinking we're going to have some tree damage, some power line issues just from the wind. You add the rain and the saturated grounds, you add the weight of the snow onto those tree branches. Either way, it's just adding to that problem. Midday, 30, 40, 50 mile per hour winds from DC to Baltimore to Philly. Overnight, you start getting those winds into New York. By morning, you're getting those kinds of winds into Boston. So everybody gets a taste of those very strong winds here. A long duration onshore wind event, especially from Long Island South. You get a piece of that on the east-facing beaches of eastern Massachusetts. So, coastal flood advisory there. Coastal flood watch coming down Long Island Sound and pointed at the Battery. I think the poster child for the coastal flood issues here is going to be the Jersey Shore. A little piece of that into Delaware as well. 2 days or so removed from the new moon, so already high tides, and then that wind not helping, a large swath of snow on the way.
Our 12-step process provides 100% pure quality water.
Now try Nestle Pure Life Plus, water enhanced with minerals and a splash of flavor.
One taste of Nespresso Virtuo, and Michaela G. writes, one taste and you'll discover what coffee is meant to be. Nespresso Virtuo.
I'm a Verizon engineer, part of the team that built 5G right. We started with America's most reliable network, added 5G nationwide for millions of Americans, and the unprecedented performance of ultra-wideband in more and more places where people need massive capacity and ultra-low lag. I'm proud ultra-wideband was named the fastest 5G in the world. But I'm even more proud all that work is going to make a real difference for you. This is the 5G America's been waiting for, only from Verizon.
Hey, I didn't order any pizza.
Jake from State Farm. After you saved me so much dough on insurance with that Parker promo, I devised a promo for you.
Here's the deal, Parker. State Farm offers everyone surprisingly great rates.
Yeah, right. Pepperoni pockets, an atomic brownie, cuckoo crusty.
There's no promo, it's just great rates.
And a side of ranch. You're the man, man.
When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
One of the worst things about a cold sore is how it can make you feel. But when used at the first sign, Abreva can get you back to being you in just 2.5 days. Be kinder to yourself and tougher on your cold sores.
You give your time. You give your courage. You soldier through and make us proud. Which is why we are giving our employee price to you. That's the same great price we get. Because you show us who we are at our best and why we serve.
With employee pricing for all during the Ram Big Finish event, get an average $9,860 below MSRP on the 2021 Ram 1500.
This holiday, find stylish gifts for all the diamonds in your life. Get 30% off everything and find one-of-a-kind deals at the You Are My Diamond event. Now extended through December 19th. Shop online with the virtual consultant. Zales, the diamond store.
Every morning at 4:30, you hear the cooks hop on the floor. It's hard times in the mill, my love, hard times in the mill. Every morning right at 6, don't that old bell make you sick? Hard times in the mill, my love, hard times.
I'm Carl Parker. Major winter storm is on the way for the Northeast, and it's going to be developing tomorrow and then stepping up through the day tomorrow. We are talking about a terrific amount of snow on the way for much of Pennsylvania, as well as northern Jersey and southeast New York, and then a lot of New England on top of that. And this, by the way, is a higher confidence forecast. We know that that part of it is likely to happen. It's going to be quite a snowstorm with a lot of wind on top of that, so we could be looking at some near blizzard or maybe even some blizzard conditions. Where we're less sure about what's going to happen is through this area and there. Let me narrow that even more, just like that. That's where it's a lower confidence forecast, and that is necessarily going to be the case when you have a transition from a lot of snow to not very much to none at all over a short distance, over, say, 20 to 30 to 40 miles. When that's the case, a little bit of a shift in the track of the low could make a very, very big difference. So it appears now that D.C. and Baltimore are in for less snow, and there's going to be more in northern Maryland. Pennsylvania, really, really tricky. Southeast Pennsylvania and Philadelphia in particular, very, very tricky. Could be that there's quite a bit in the north side of the metro, but not much at all on the south side. And then New York is probably going to be in for a foot of snow and more. But we're going to watch rain creeping into the south, and that will cut down on the total. So in all of those areas, from Washington right up through New York, there is uncertainty in the forecast, and that's an important part of this. And then here you see the timing of this snow coming in tomorrow morning in D.C., and then the snow developing through parts of Pennsylvania and New York into tomorrow evening, and the wind getting a lot stronger on top of that. We'll have much more starting tomorrow morning at 5 a.m.